Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Okay, karon ako diyan na ko. Sure. Okay, what was the title of the message when Kuya Eddie spoke about level up? What's the main point? Practice? Okay. Just raise your hand if you wanted to speak great. Kisa king at ang study during the first message. What's the name of the king? First, ng Kuya Eddie. See? Yes. See? David? No, it's not David. First kid. First session. Si Kuya Eddie, any message? See? Okay, raise your hand. Yes.
Hosea.
Grace, who's Ate Grace? Would you please give, what's your name? Vincent. Oh, it's Vickery. Okay, Starbucks, eh? Sorry, Starbucks, eh?
Starbucks.
Okay, during the second session, we had just spoke about King Josiah. Okay? Just raise your hand. If you want to give the answer, what was the message, the main thing that we just talked about?
Study faithfully.
Sakto ba ba dyan?
Yes.
Yes, sakto ba to? Study faithfully?
Yes.
Okay, sakto daw. Okay, Grace, please give Neil Starbuck.
Neil.
Okay, anyway, please go. Now, we're going to continue our last series na tutuon sa level up. Now, when are you going to play Dota or are you going to play any RPG game or forward game on your cell phone, you want that to beat the high score, di ba? Okay. Pag na-register na taas na score, what's our tendency? To beat the high score because you and I are wired that way. We want to level up. Okay, now, today, we're gonna end this
series.
And, Pac-Man. Okay, so, but we want to level up. Now, do you know this guy? So, anyway, this guy is, what's the name of this guy? Do you know this guy? I had this message during the Get Real series, and it said there, this guy's name was Kanye West. Diba? Asmani Kim Kardashian. So, anyway, this is what he said over these radios. BBC Radio 1's Zane Lowe in 2013, when he was asked, when someone comes up and says something like, I am a God, everybody says, who does he think he is? And this is what he said, I just told you who I thought I was, a God. I just told you that's who I think I am. Wow. That is a person. He thinks that he's a God. That was in 2013. What's the year today? 2016. Last month, this is what he said over Twitter. It says there, Valentine's Day. What's the date? 10:46 a.m. Ano Twitter? Okay. I write to you, my brothers, while still 53 million in personal debt. Wow, palutak na God. But he says that he's a God, but and he said, please, pray, overcome. This is my true heart. Realization struck this God. If he who claims who he is. Therefore, if he's a God, I don't want to worship him. Right? Even him asking people, please pray for me that I can overcome. Amen. personal debt is $53 million. That's the reason why we're going through this level up. If you really wanted to level up, what will you do? Because this guy is exalting himself. He's attributing himself as God. And look at this, Matthew 23, 12. It says, could you please write? Let's read this all together. Come on. Let's read this verse. Ready, go. Whoever exalts himself shall be humbled, and whoever humbles himself shall be exalted. Shall we ask God's wisdom in the word of prayer? Father, thank you so much once again for times like these where we can have fun together as a family and at the same time worship you through songs and hymns. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to be here, and we thank you, Lord, for your grace. Lord, we ask for your wisdom as we delve into your word, and I pray, Lord, that you just use me, Lord, to communicate, to connect your message to these young people, Lord. You bless them, Lord, bless also the time together. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. May now be seated. Okay, now last week, talk about King Josiah. Meaning you have to study faithfully. Now if you really wanted to level up, if you really wanted to level up through God's word, you have to study faithfully. Now this time, level up. My message today is that level up down on your knees. But yeah, it's oxymoron. What do you mean oxymoron? Mura siya, positive, negative, hindi siya mag-connect yan. Level up, tapos down. Okay, we will try to go through that in a matter of minutes. Now, level up down on your knees. Just tell yourself things. Level up down on your knees. Okay. Now, since we're studying the life of the kings of Judah, these are the life of the king that we're going to follow. Last week, we talked about Josiah. And he reigned Judah for 31 years. Peter mentioned about it. And this is his great grandfather, Hezekiah. Now, I purposefully highlight their yellow so that you will know. Hezekiah and Josiah, they were basically the good guys. They were the good kings during their time. And Hezekiah reigned for 29 years. But you know what? Manasseh, the son of Hezekiah, reigned for 55 years, the longest ever. And a reign is like a king in Judah, 55 years. Now, why Kuya Delicielo? Because he's a bad king. Now, after Manasseh is Amon, he only reigned for 2 years because he was assassinated by his own people. And then, that's the reason why Josiah succeeded Amon at the age of 8. Do you follow? Okay, now, we're going to talk about Manasseh. Since he's a dugay and a great sa Judah. Unlike his father, Hezekiah, this is what Hezekiah did. Okay? Hezekiah did right in the sight of the Lord according to all his ancestors. His ancestor is David. They came from the line of David. Okay? That's what Hezekiah did. But if you're gonna look at the life of Manasseh, you will be so sickening. Dugon ka, kasutuol ka sa iyong life. Why? This is what he did. Before we go there, Manasseh was 12 years old when he became king and he reigned 55 years old in Jerusalem. Now, can you say 12 years old today? 12 years old. And I mean 12. Okay, anyone younger than 12? 12, 11. 9 to Petey. Petey, you're 9, right? Okay. Now, imagine this. He said, well, that's come on. You're already king or queen or burning. You're already the president of the Philippines at the age of 12. Now, I'm a babae that had the president in our life. Yes, baseball, yeah, maybe. Imagine. What's your name? Alice. Alice is running for president. Will you vote for Alice? What? Or see, Tori, you run for president at the age of 12. Imagine Manasseh became king. He's not running. He's already came in Judah during the time. And he reigned Jerusalem for 55 years. Oh boy. That's quite long. But nothing. And you know what? Okay, it's barely anything anyway. Before anyway, in Dawah na 13. But si Sean, kauna, sa teens pa siya, si Sean, pinaedad mo siya, kapila ko grade 4. Pero grade 4, right? Grade 4, pamukos yun, sila mati, kapila ka, kapila yung 13. Diba, Mike? Yung first, join the first camp sa teens, you're still in elementary? Supposedly, but it's no offense. Actually, we're happy that you're here at a young age. We welcome those 11, 10, 11, 12, 13 sa elevated. Even college, we welcome them in elevated high school. Now, this is the problem. He did what he knew? Evil in the sight of the Lord according to the abomination. Now, what's abomination in Tagalog? Kahindi-hindi na suklam-suklam. Where? In the eyes of the Lord. Why? When Israelites came out of Egypt, diba, God gave Israelites Canaan. The inhabitants of Canaan during that time. That's the reason why God drove them out because they were so abome nabolo. Dili naman, God hates it. What do they do in Canaan? They offer their children to their gods. Now, Baal worshippers, are you familiar with the word Baal? Because the Bible would say Baal, it's an idol. Right? Baal is the god of Canaan. What is the god of Canaan? I mean, they have gods, so many gods. What did they do is that they offered their firstborn child. Kisa ka mga firstborn din? Firstborn. Okay, example lang, asa ko mo, higher. Because I will sacrifice you today. Just kidding. No, this is what the parents will do. The Canaanite parents, this is what they will do. They will offer their firstborn child to Baal so that, no, maybe offer it sacrifice, diba? So therefore, you have to kill the child and offer the blood to Baal. And that's what they practice during that time. The firstborn child, so that they will gain personal prosperity. Because they believe that Baal is the god of fertility and prosperity. And this is what Manasseh did. His father get rid of all idolatry in the land of Judah, but Manasseh, he did the opposite. And then, what did he do? He rebuilt the high places which Hezekiah has turned down. Now when we look at the high places in the Bible, what does it mean? High places, these are the technical term used for cultic platform. When you say platform, that's kind of a common. Platform siya for idol worship. For culto. Diba? You know what's culto? Huh? If you see your neighbor, you know, tapos ang dupo, tigyan, anak, dito sa palibot sa gambalay, what will you think? Huh? Tapos mahurim-hurim siya, wala ka kasabot, what will you do? Maranaan ka. Mahirap ka nila. Of course, that's the end of a platform para sa human sacrifice. Those are considered that high places. And it looks like this. You know what? Hezekiah, the dad of Manasseh, got rid of all these things. And here comes Manasseh, when he succeeded his dad, he rebuilt all these things. That's the reason why the Bible is very clear that Manasseh did evil and abominable in the sight of God. Detestable. What else did he do? He also erected altars for the Baals and the Asherim. And worship all the hosts of the heaven and serve them. You know what are the hosts of heaven? Like example, we look at the stars, the moon, the sun, the trees, all those things, those are hosts of heaven. Those were creation, not the creator. So Manasseh, instead of worshiping the creator, Manasseh served and worshiped the God. gods of the Canaan, which is the enemy of God.
Do you follow?
And then, not only that, he built altars in the house of the Lord. No, the house of the Lord is supposed to be the house of the Lord. Right? That's why God commanded Solomon, which the Lord has said, my name shall be in Jerusalem forever. And that's the grand plan of God, because he wanted to lift up or to elevate or to lift up these people. If you're a child of God, you know exactly what's the plan of God for you. Whether you like it or not, if you are a child of God, iyan yung kanya. Do you follow? God will level you up, meaning he will elevate you. But you know what? Manasseh did the opposite. In contrast to what God commanded Moses, by build altars for all the hosts of heaven, two courts in the house of the Lord. When God commanded Moses, this is what God said to Moses. God himself spoke to Moses and said, do not turn to idols or make for yourselves mountain gods. I am the Lord your God. What Manasseh is doing is a complete mockery against God. When you disobey God, you mock God. You mock the character of God. Let's continue. He made his sons. This is the worst thing that Manasseh did. He sacrificed his own son to the fire. He practiced witchcraft. You know what's witchcraft? Barang, kukulang, whatever it is in the Tagalog. Used divination, spiritista, practiced sorcery, magic, and dealt with mediums and spiritists. What God has to do? Also, maybe he's saying about these things. You know what? God, this is the picture. Yet he offered a son to the gods of the Canaanites. And boy, God hates that. God hates that, right? Manasseh did much evil in the sight of the Lord. We will continue. Verse 6, provoking God to anger. Now, I can ask you, have you been provoked to anger? What will you react? Kung i-provoke ka? Ha? Mag-strong ka? Mag-indok na buhok? Kahit ingipon? You get the picture? That's exactly what Manasseh did to God. I-provoke God to anger. Now this is what God said. If you're going to offer your sons in Leviticus chapter 20, if you're going to offer your sons to the idols, now this is the God of the Amorites, Moloch, you will be put to death. If you will ignore it, in verse 20, this is what God said. You're supposed to be put to death. If you're a father, and you're an Israelite, and you follow the ways of the Amorite, you sacrifice your child to the gods of the Canaanites, you will be put to death. But if you will ignore it, what did God say? I myself will set my face against that man and against his family, and I will cut off from among their people both him and all those who play the harlot after him by playing the harlot after Molly. You know what? Right? Supposedly, God is a jealous God. He only wanted to be worshipped. You get the point? God wants you to be faithful only to Him. Now, gusto mo faithful na spouse in the future? Huh? Then practice faithfulness. Hindi mo kung sulti nga. Gusto ko faithful ako girlfriend na ako ang itiyam boyfriend member. Tapos ikaw, grabe, grabe ka mo yan, wala ko. Diba? Same thing with God. You cannot come to God's presence kung nakarnitang worship other things. God wants your heart. God wants you. And God wants you to worship Him alone. You shall not eat anything. This is what else what does Manasseh do? He practiced divination. In Leviticus, It also says that they need more practice and determination for soothsaying. Now, how does soothsaying? It is in NLP, it says, do not eat meat that has not been drained of its blood. Do not practice fortune telling or witchcraft. It means casting a spell, or ana in Hebrew. When you say soothsaying, you cannot become boring, or Harry Potter. Yes? Okay, do not practice that. When I say, do not anything with blood. We have paon ng tinubuan. Okay, question. Kung paon ng tinubuan, na loko yung narili? Of course, loko. Now, we can, I don't want us to argue in this area. Okay? You shall not eat anything with blood. Okay? Makinilaw mo siguro mo ang kugasan ng tinubuan niyo, you have to remove the blood. Okay? Kung makita ninyo ang mga practices, witchcraft, and vampires, and werewolves, usually, what say makita ninyo? Associate ninyo, dugo, fresh blood, why? Ngayon mo na siya, kaya kung talk about evil, but it is conflicted with blood. Do you know that life is in the blood? And God said, do not take in the blood, but drain it. But degrading yung blood, do not take that. Now, I don't know about you, it's your personal condition. Ako, I used to eat tinubuan. Diba? Bawal ang tao ng tinubuan, basta wala yung puto. Honestly, I eat tinubuan, but for health reasons, no, this is my condition, for health reasons, I know that mas lahat ka mga puto sa kit kung mabawal ng dugo. But, I'm not saying na dilaw ng dugo. The context of Leviticus 19:26 is fresh blood. Okay? Okay, usually, it is associated with practice of divination, so say, nakita ninyo ang connection? Okay, more than exactly what Manasseh, I'm not talking about mukha o mong dinuguan ng puto, nag-practice ng mga witchcraft. Wala mo siguro? Ako, I'm not eating dinuguan for health reasons, as I've said. Okay? Your condition, hindi pa kaya mong tao ng puti tiruan tapos mahurin-hurin mo. Okay? Muna siya yung context ni Manasseh. Now, let's look at this, continue. Manasseh did much evil in the sight of the Lord. When you say evil, it is totally detestable, it totally disagreeable against God, therefore provoking God to anger. Then, not only that, grabe siya kalapas tangan kung sa Tagalog pa. What is that in Isaiah? Huh? I don't know. Then he put the carved image of the idol where? In the house of God. So this is the picture. This is the porch, this is the temple of God, this is the porch. We place all the idols there in all corners. Grabe, he's not supposed to do that. This is God's temple. That's what is in God. This is where it will be my place. A mockery against God and then provoking God to anger. Now, how do we mock God? Do you know this guy? Do you know this guy? Now, this guy is an MMA champion. He goes to from one class to another, and then in December 3, 2015, he made a media comment. This is what he said. If Jesus and I were in octagon, I could still be Jesus. And all the pastors of the state, they really had this uproar that we will pray this guy will be humbled. And eventually, you know, when he said this, he made his comment in December last year. Last March 5, he was beaten. Didn't siya nagtiting at house or something. He was beaten by a submission. What is a submission? You surrender. Eh, ito na po, ito lang mo. May surrender siya. He gave up. In humble submission. What does the book of Proverbs tell us? That pride goes before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. Now let's continue. Galatians 6:7 says, that do not be deceived, God is not mocked. For whatever man sows, what? He will also win. That means that the name of the guy was Conor McGregor. Conor McGregor. If mock God, then that's where what Hiris. Now let's continue with Manasseh. What else did Manasseh do? He put the carved image of this idol in the house of God, of which God, supposedly this is what God designs. God said to David and Solomon, his son, in this house and in Jerusalem, which I have chosen from all the tribes of Israel, I will put my name forever. You and I, we don't have anything to blame because who chooses who? Who chose Israel to be his chosen people? Who chose Israel? God. Wala tayong karapatan na manghinampog. We can be proud of our accomplishment. We're the chosen people of God. We're Christians, the only Christian nation in this Southeast Asia. Because you know what? Who have chosen you to be here? Who have chosen to save you? Na makailangan ka sa diyan na kasi Christ. It was God. So you have to understand this, that the path to humility is God initiated. You can take it and pray. Israel, Judah, Manasseh, and even the kings have no reason to be proud because it was God who chose them. To put His name in them, well, forever. And to put them in a place where God wants them to be so that God can level them up. May follow? Level them up. If you have God's name in you forever, as what I said, you don't have any choice but God will lift you up. And this is what God promises them. I will not again remove the foot of Israel from the land which I have appointed you for your fathers. If only, there's the petition. If only you will what? Observe to do all I have commanded them according to all the law, the statutes and the ordinances given to Moses. Now, as I was having my devo this morning, I came across Psalms of God chapter 19, and it says there, the law of the Lord is pure, the law of the Lord is righteous, the statutes of the Lord, they are always are of high regard. And you know what Manasseh did? He disregarded the law, he disobeyed the Lord, and what does he do? He did evil in the sight of God. So what have we learned? If we are really in awe of God's word and who God is, what we will do? We will respond in humble obedience. We will level up down our knees. How do we level up? With all humility. Level up down your knees to humble obedience. This is what C.S. Lewis said. A proud man is always looking down on things and people. And of course, as long as you're looking down, you can see something that's above you. If you're wanted to level up, get down on your knees and humble obedience. Why? So that you can see what's up there. Eh kung sige lang tagaan na sa ilan, makakuloy mo ayaw. But, di pa ka makakita kung sa tunas taas. But if you get down on your knee, get down on your knee, and lift up, you will see the grace of God. So what's the message? Level up, down on your knees, out, through, on both knees. Now, this is what Manasseh did. Diba? Grabe, let me summarize. You'll see, can you? He disobeyed God. Number one, he disobeyed God. This is the commandment of the Lord. Okay? What else did he do? He rebuilt all the idols. He worshipped all the idols. He served the idols. He even sacrificed his own child to the God of the Canaanites. And not only that, he put the idols in the house of the Lord. Grabe si Manasseh. If I were God, I would not forgive Manasseh. Diba? Good thing, I'm not God. I'm not Kanye West. But thus Manasseh misled Judah, the inhabitants of Jerusalem, to do more evil than the nations whom the Lord destroyed before the sons of Israel. Katoy naman po for some time, they were doing evil things. That's the reason why God destroyed them. But here comes the people of God mismo, sila yung evil things against God. And the Lord spoke to Manasseh, and he even sent prophets to speak to Manasseh that they have to repent, to rebuke them. You know what you're doing is evil in the sight of the Lord, and you're provoking God to anger. But what did Manasseh? What was Manasseh's reply? They ignored. Okay. I'm comfortable with the way we worship God. And so God initiated something. You don't want it to happen? I'll get you down on your knees. Just honor McGregor. Just like the newest. 2 Chronicles 33:11, God sent forth the armies of Assyria, and they defeated Jerusalem. This is what they did. And they captured Manasseh with hooks bound with bronze chains and took him to Babylon. So, pumunta na nila chains si Manasseh dun sa ilong, sino ni Buyon? Diba? Path to humility. You have to understand this, that God initiated. Path, you want to be humble, if people don't want to be humble, you know what? God will initiate humility. You will do things. And this is what Manasseh then, when he was in Babylon and he was in distress, wala na siya pag-asa. He was so weak, so powerless. He entreated the Lord his God. He remembered the Lord. When you say entreat, meaning you beg for mercy. Lord, kaloy tiko. In Hebrew, it means chala, meaning to become sorry, to become grieved. Meaning to implore, to beg for mercy, to pray, to beseech, lifting up your petition. And then it says there, he humbled himself. How? How?
Greatly.
So what's that? Humble greatly. Manasseh is now down on his knees before the God of his fathers. Verse 13, it says there, when he prayed to God, to him, what was the response of God? This is amazing. God was moved by his entity and heard his supplication and brought him again to Jerusalem, his kingdom. Who restored Manasseh? Huh? Who humbled him down? Huh? He said, humble saya. Who sent the Assyrian army? God. Humility is God initiated. Well, then Manasseh, this is the good way. Look at this, gathering this all together. Then Manasseh knew that the Lord was God. When you say knew, did you get experience who God is? And then when Manasseh experienced who God was in his life, he began to humble down on his knees. What's the message? Level up now on your knees through humble obedience. Now, if you're going to speak, we have a change passing Manasseh. Now, let's go ahead. Because the story of Manasseh is not the end. Now, yeah, he knew that the Lord was God. Let's look at this. He revealed the gates of Jerusalem and even the temple courts. Now, we'll just have to read that. He revealed the temple courts, the gates. And he also, what? Look at 13, 15. He also removed the foreign gods and the idol from the house of the Lord, as well as the altars which he had built on the mountain and the house of the Lord in Jerusalem. What else did he do? He threw them outside of the city. He set up what? The altar and sacrificed peace offerings and thank offerings on it. And he, not only he and his family, he ordered Judah, meaning the entire nation, to what? To serve the Lord God of Israel. Amazing. Nevertheless, the people still sacrifice. Yes, they still sacrifice in the high places, meaning the mountains and all these things in the altars. But although only to the Lord. So there was there a reformation in the entire life? A change was that? That's what we call repentance. Repentance is this. Look at me. Repentance is this. Turning away from sin. If sin is over here, turning away from sin and turning to God. That's what exactly the people should have did through Manasseh. Now, I'm going to ask you, the rest of the acts of Manasseh, if you could say, we have grabe ba si God na forgive mo kaya pala si Manasseh? Manasseh was amputaw? Are you with me? Was he amputaw? Okay, now, all the acts of Manasseh, his prayers, his indignity, all those things, indignity, how he humbled himself, how was he captured, and how he built all the idols in the land, they were recorded in the book of the Chronicles. So what's the message? Level up, down on your knees, you humble obedience. Now, what's the opposite of humility? Humble. Proud. But I mean, opposite of humility is pride. Opposite of humbleness is proud. Okay. And the path to humility, as what I mentioned, is initiated by God. Now, if God initiated humility, how do we follow God? Now, God sent forth His Son, Jesus Christ, as our model. Now, I want to request everyone to please read this. Philippians 2:3. Ready, go. Do nothing from selfishness or empty conceit, but with humility of mind, regard one another as more important than yourselves. Do not merely look out for your own personal interests, but also for the interests of others. Let's pause there. It's not bad to look for your own personal interest. But it says there, not merely look for your own personal interest, but you have to look out for the interest of others. You try to encounter this. If you're going to read this verse and you wanted to put this into practice, and here you are, falling in line, linya ka, because you wanted to be enrolled. Kasi ka pa enrolled sa inyo? In your parents? Ikaw ka mura? Kasi ka enrolled sa inyong self? Ask ka mong bin? Kasi ka pa enrolled sa inyong self? Sa school? Asta mo? Katong ka pa enrolled? Kapag na mag-enrolled sa inyong self? Okay. Praise God. Okay. You learn to enroll yourself. Linya na pa kayo pa enroll ka sa inyong self. Taas kayo linya, tapos hapit tayo mong third, tapos somebody may insert. What would you do? Okay, what if you read this verse and you wanted to practice this? Do not merely look out for your own personal interest, but the interest of others. Lord! That's what I'm saying. You want to experience the path to humility, you have to understand that this is God initiated. Second, look at this. Have this attitude in yourselves, which was where? In Christ Jesus, who, although he existed in the form of God, did not regard equality with God, a thing to be grasped. Now remember the downfall of Lucifer. He wanted to be God. But what did Jesus do? He emptied himself. Taking the form of one servant, he washed the feet of his disciples. And being made in the likeness of man, what did he do? He found appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming what? Obedient to the point of death, even though death on the cross. Path to humility, it is God initiated. Second, it is Jesus model. And third, right? When Jesus was about to be crucified, this is what he told his disciples. I'm talking about the Holy Spirit. Because I'm not gonna leave you before saving you. Yes, physically Jesus is not here. But Jesus promised someone, the Holy Spirit. Path to humility, God initiated, Christ modeled, third, Spirit empowered. Spirit empowered. Now, why am I saying this? Because you and I cannot really be down on our knees. without God. If you really truly wanted to be leveled up, look up. And usually what we're doing is that we're looking down at others. How do we do that? Look at Christ. Humble obedience. Now I'm going to invite a brother of ours. His name is Quailwell. And he's going to give you his testimony. Please listen. How God leveled him up when he put himself down in the presence of God. Bro.
Pero ay, dapat ko sa sipa, sa bago, kurata, sa papa, at ngayon sa kabalang mo naman ba? Yeah, dili ba ni show is ang emotions sa talaga, feelings naman. For example, ang papa, pakilabi sa mga. Nilad na ako 28, karoon ako kalimog na, hindi ko na ako papakilabi sa mga. So, para sa mga, pag lahir ng iba, wala naman nakita kita na walang kakas ng parents. Eh, nabot ang panahon na ako, sa sige nung kita kawa sa kaya, hindi na ako dawatan sa eskulahan sa kick-out ko na ang last option sa mong parents na mabilisod magdawat ako ang eskulahan sa ko ay eskwela ko sa bukid nun. So, pagkabot sa bukid nun, ito sa mong lula. Isa mo, kung isa ko sa kaya, nasa isa mo, dodo ko eh. Ito, wala pang nga lula gabantay sa buka. So, ito ang experience ang grabe ng mga disyo kaaway ba eh. Dahil ng tagasulat niya, ang kapag bilang ng probinsya, ng pagkakapayasan, mga paminaw, kaya mga blab na ito ako. Kapag nakita yung mga ayos ang pagmahal, pero pagkabot na lang ito, masanay, tanaw mo mga magalato sa ko, ang rato ng isang bagay rin. Kasi magagalato ko sa ko, isang bagay ito, kaya na ba ito? Akong natural, kung ikaw iro, kung ikaw ba, basta na iro na ako. Yung mga kakakiro na may barkada ka sa Monterrey. So pag-abot ako, tapos di ba ako yung mga barkada ito, parinabi ko sa buwan. Isyoso ang mga laban ng mga iba na may kakao ng Mandili. So, ito, naka-create na po ako ng grupo na ito. Sa Jimmy Kitag Away, naka-experience kaysa sa diskuhan sa akong amigo. Kaya ako may hiking ko sa marijuana. Para ako matang, para napaka ng kukiwukan, na nasa play na itong kit na kayo mong matang. Kaging miracle, ipuhit lang ko niya, kaya daw kabayad ang itiilog. O, atake rin ko, sumbag na ko. Magpag, ito lang yung sumbag eh. It's convict niya. Ito lang sa kibawi ko pa, kung ano, ika niya nag-preso sa Cebu, pinapatuhin. Sa huli siya sa kibawi. Sa pagpuyot niya sa kibawi, 2 years siya na ito, it's convict niya, lugar pa ng buwag, isa kay kailangan na ako i-sprayer ang mga kasama ang uncle ko. So, tinunggap siya ito sa ilog, pero na sobra nila nga ba, pinahirap na sila. So, ako tayo katulog. Pag sinumbagay na ako, nataranta sa ulo siya ba. Pag gusto lang sa ako, wala na nabihan yung Batangas na ito. Sakit yung ngayon, ipong tao na yata ito. Nangit-ngit kayo. So ako, pagduol sa mga barangay tanod, yung pagbukot naman. Lagi kong galis na kita pag ako, okay, ginamay ko eh, kaki mo rin ko, nakabatay ko sa kiti sa ako, ginamay ko, nalunggaban ko. Buwan ko nila, magbubo. Grabe, nagbunan ko sa mga mga unang kalanggong eh, kung nang kapayulan-payulan ko, diba? So, i-praise ka niya, ang mga tao, sa tatong mapanahon ba? Pero kamay na kaya yung ako, hindi mo nga ako mamatay ito, pero happy ko, diba? So, well, experience na ako, maglakaw na sinilingiling eh, sa karagdan sa kontra. Experience na ako, bumalag ba ito? Natapangan ko sa kabarangayan ko naman. Nali yung pasikat ba? Yung mga kaupan na naganyan, ito na lang yung pabilit eh. Pagkita laki kita, may laki kita sa kagandungan. Nabot ko ka ganyan eh, pacheck up ang buwan. Siko, may bumalag ng bato. Ano ang ulo ulit kami yan, nag-extrain na kapag sa papa. Sakay ko dito, magkabalan ngayon mo ulit. Nagsakay na ako sa kaisa ng pansit ko, sige ko sigari niyo ko. Ginahinay dalay sa iyo, kung ikakaw, pinagandagan ba? Naka-uniform of medical. Sakit kayo ako, hindi kakaw, pinagandagan. Sininawag ko, ang higupo siya. Ang gawin, ang gagaw. Tabangan ko kung buo, kung kapalo. Awang kama lang kay, bubang ko kaya. No, pinakawal na ako ng preso, dahil nito sa Cagayan, sa Ragatlaw. Nabuti sa point ba, ang preso ko, natural, yung mga auntie, ako ko, yung naganahan sa kong sa kibataan na yun, tapok-tapok nila yung eksperyalan. Ando na yung mga papa, 18 na mga edad, na yung mga papa, sa unahan ng mga loto. Edad po 19, doon ako manak. Wala ko yung normal, so wala ko yung taong trabaho. Kapidwa ka po pagkandunod. Nag-iipon niya sa balay sa mga mga, limami ko mansuon. Na mama sa mga anak, sa isa sa kabalay, ang papa na trabaho. Imagine niyo sa kubot, ang mama sa mga anak, ako ang mama din kasi nabot. Ako, kumpleto ko sa mission ako. Ako kinitaan sa mga trabaho, what? Kulang na sa mga mission. Grabe ka kubot, ito na ang experience, gusto mong bagay sa mga papa. Kung mama, kung natapatan eh. Wala na mong sabot ba? Sa kalisig siya na po eh, kung nga nangitabo sa buha. Sige po, kita kaaway, sa mga agoy po ka. So nalaisay lang nga sa mga anak, sige, trabaho mo ba bro? Uli ka di ba awi? Dato ko sa mga bata, grabe na lang ka malulong sa mga bisyo, pero ang itabo, bali lang di ba awi? Mas kasama mo pa sa mga bisyo, okay? Nanay ka padala sa katagulan, ang kwarta, nga, naroon sa balay, buhat, ganigosyo, kung siya mo siya ako, nabulat ka. Nabot, malulong na kayo, malulong, apil akong mga anak, nakabalo na sila bitaw, kung saan siya po, yun sa pagdaw sa siya po sa ilang papa o sa ilang kinabuhi ba? Bitaw rin ba yun ang mga nao?
Nag-listod na ako sa araw na ako pagkaligawa sa mission na sa atin.
sa unang pagpahibalo sa mama sa mga anak na nakapagulo sa kulayan ng bayan. Siya rin ang buhig sa kuha sa mga anak. So siya mo rin pa-espela at ako ang sildo. Kamay naman so. At that time, may plano niya may magpakasal ng anak doon. Uli doon niya magpakasal. Paano nalibog na ako, naging painan. Kaya, hindi na makalata ang pleasure sa kuha ang droga, inom. So, nangita ko kay Storyan daw na maminaw sa kuha. Pero, sa gara maminaw sa kuha, ito naman i-text na ako, okay, inom ka. Nawag problema, so, abot-abot nito, Storyan, inom. Mabili, uman, droga, maminaw sa mga kay droga. Ako, wala na, maminadang nabuhi ko. Wala na yung kitain na nanay ko. So, hindi buwan, magsimba ko. 3 times a week ko masimba. Kadyan dyan na ako kumukuhan. May ito, may puti na, may babae. Kung saan yung lugan ng tulog, may tanay box, bulog, ano na nga na pumakir. Kumoto nga, sa atlaw, tanaw, sa lidar. Nanay, kanang, hair killer. So, tatlo nga si, every time ako man siya, saya, o at sa iyang trabaho, kapatay siya na nalay sa kanya ni Rocky ng lugar na tayo may bahanas ko na. So, storya-storya siya na ito. Anong mura ko dito niya pagkawa sa mga problema, ayan na siguro ko. Ayan ako na, kapag yung nalay sa kaya, ayan na, maminaw na sa ako ko. Storya ni, natampagan ko, sinap sa problema na ako yung katampagan na. Nay, doon kaya po ang panahon na yun. Ito sa buwan, anak level na sa Malbele, anak na sa third floor. Tato lang lang ito, kung nakakal na yung number. Sinyan to ko. Sa pamina ko, bowling, kaya yun. Isa na lang mga problema, isa na ito. Ko, anak ang problema. Isa na lang mga problema. Alibalo ng iskila, bigilap na yung anak. Bowling, kaya yun. Pag ako na iskila sa problema, ako na. Huwag mo kayo inanawang, ang sabali natin, una sila ginama. Takas kayo mo una sa ito, ano sa mga pag-anak, kung i-share sila ano sa tatong at lang, ang kakot lang ito, sa mga drama mo ako. Ganda nga na ito. Anto na, kumana mo share sila, may nigo sa mga isa. Bro, ito tapos, may ganda. Kaya kung mamatay na, bro, ito na mamatay ka. Haga pa yun, bro. Ito, ano, ito, ano, ito, namatay ko sa lito. Ako na ako sa mga blackout ng lugar na ang mga rin nakatulog. Wala na rin yung nana ko. So, ang doon i-share yung Kasper sa bus. And that time na yung i-share daw sa bus, ako mo sa mga balay. Ako ang hihilang ng tanan sa Ginoong Lord. Tinuod ka, Lord. Makuha ako, tinabuhi ako. Sa university ko nga, buhod di ko ilago. Anak, hindi ka lang tawag na ako sa Muslim na ito. Magtuwal-tuwal lang ako yung iba sa balay. Disurrender ka na akong kinabuhi, Lord. Kung tinuod ka, Lord, pakuha ko, Lord, eh, buhat na akong aparang bako, huwag ina nagaya. Kung tinuod ka, Lord, surrender ako, kinabuhi ako sa inyo, ikaw ay bahala, wala akong mula, Lord. So, kakuha na ako, ha, kakuha na ako ni Jesus Christ, ako na, kadunog ako ni Jesus Christ. Para sa kuha, bilik ka may mong believer, bilik mo siya sundan. For example, si yung papa, matuwa ko na ikaw, papa niyo na, kung subuhol ka niya, ngayon sa tuwal. Diba, ngayon ka, papa naman na, pagsugo sa inyo, magbukil lang mo, anak, tuwo mo sa inyo. Kaya na sa mga ba, so, dilit ka ngayon yung believer, dilit mo siya sundan. So, ako ba, ni-follow ito ni Christ na kung ila-ila o isa niya yung Ginoo, okay, anak ko, Ginoo naman yung Christ ko lang, so, dapat careful ka pinsan ng Ginoo, so, ila-ila lang si Jesus Christ, ila-ila, ang tagpagay, nasabtan ako, ngayon hinta ko, sa buha, pero again, nasabtan ako, nanong nakapa ng sitwasyon, nanong nakapa ng kalimutan na, nana, nasabtan ako. So, gulad doon ako, grabe yung kabagkuhan sa akin na buhay, nagpuyo ko nga, hindi ko yung secured with the level, kung may kahilukan, wala ko ang nagkabalakan. Nakita na ako ang kung saan nagwapos sa kinabuhi na nagulat pag isa ko ako ato. Morning ang pamilya na ako ang kwaso. Ito na, ilailan na ako ang ginawa na ang relasyon ni Jesus Christ. So ako, ana, isa ka lang ako na ako na rin istorya sa mama sa mga anak. So, Lord, saling ko sa mo ha. Kung sa mga kay may tabo, sa mga kay desisyon, imuha ganyan, hindi ako ang will na sa imuha ganyan will, Lord. So, abalo mo ko, imuha ang plano, Lord. Mas maayo kaysa akong plano. Mas nakaibalo ako sa maayo. So, hindi man pwede, Lord. Ako may tabo ni saya sa akong istorya. So, New Year pa din, mas busy sa gabi, sa 31 December. Itagbo na mga New Year, ano ko sa mama sa mga anak. Pag-awin ako yung istorya sa mga sa mga na, tapos ka ka. Pag-awin ako kaya yung anak ko sa lahat, babae ba? Lagi yung bakit mo New Year. Andan, wala din yung nag-work na, so tabulan ni that time, nasa Denmark karon, nasa Amsterdam. Dugay ko nila ang tita. So ako mga anak, yan di pakuha. So ako mga anak ko sa Kitaway. Yan tuwan mo bis na binibi sa balay. Kuha mga anak. Yan sila, adik ko na rin sa ikaw. Well, ako mo sila na pamilya. So, kuha niya mga anak. Sa tiyan, isa ko yung mga anak. Ang dako, isa ko. Puro pililaki. Anto, mga na yung anak na bilis na kuha. Itong isa sa mama sa nung dalawa na babae ng mga anak dyan. Bigyan ko na ipapita ang anak sa kuha. So, sa kid kay yes. Ikaw, kung natin kay binuhanta ni Jay, naging consequence. E faithful mo na dito, iba yung isa, kung mag-repente sa mga salamat sa loob, pata faithful niya mo siya sa consequences. Pero, gusto mo na rin ang pasalat. Okay, consequence. Kaya naging pasalubon, pata. So, mawala sila tangan, mawala mga anak ng mga isa. So, kung sa'yo nawala sa buwan sa'yo nabugak agad tayo, kung siguro pinalaki ng buhay mo nabugak, ay naku isang ikagawa, hindi nakalikawa sa siya po nung kan. That time, bro, nung second year high school siya, siya kong hindi na digroup, kasi siya buhay, ako sa'yo nilatrade. Nilatrade po na karun, wala na, bubak niya kinabuhay. Sabi ka bubak sa'yo kinabuhay na, last month na, 2 months ago, nilatrade siya sa nanti ikaw, may work tayo. Siguro siya iligan. Bangga, bali, atin. Sa hapit siya mamatay. Eh. Siya po siguro niya ako na po yun. Ikan siya tibawi ako na niya po siya iligan. So, para sa kuha, nabuba. Luhoy niya, magtanawa. Nagkaroon din sila magpatuho sa kuha. Sakit niya sa buhot mo. Yan, magigitan. Pero sila rin na mamino. Blinded niya sila. Sabi ang pamilya, nabuba. Sa ako ba pagbago na kaya ng mga akura? Wala, di ba? Akong dibuhan, isurrender ako sa Ginoo, nag-repento sa mga sala. Para sa inyo, kung ikaw, imong papa, kung mama, ipatay sa inyong silingan, Roman, inyong silingan ni Jose, o makarip pa sa inyo, Roman, may muna, papuwi ako sa inyong balay. Napakan ako. Okay na ka? Dili, no, dili. Hindi na ito makaya, no? Pero kung ato siya papoy, ang mga may tawag ng grace. Ang butang ko na magrabe ka na buha, pero ang dihatag sa inyo ay sobra-sobra pa lang ang kamayo. Kaya kung pagdungog ka ng grace ka o nga, pangalan na sa mong crush, ikagaw ng mercy. But then again, ibalta na po sa grace. Tanga, grabe ka daotan na tao. Ibagaw sa Ginoo. Di ba? Yan ang kinabuhi kayo yata sa mga nagulat, grace. Pero at the time, nakadungo ka ng word na grace, like napitik sa mga kasing-kasing parang experience na kung saan grace sa Ginoo. Which is walay, lahat makahatag sa iya. Sa iyo, Lord, what? Nag-repent ako sa mga masala, or disurrender na akong kinabuhi sa iya, pero nang ihihatag sa kuwa, dili sa iyo, dili basta-basta ang ihihatag. Di ba? Di-try na ako nga ako yung bago, pero wala. Ako lang isurrender sa'yo, di bago niya akong kinabuhin. Grace. God's grace. So yun sa Proverbs 20:30, you know, sometimes it takes painful experience to make us change our ways. So painful niya sa kuha niya tapos ang pamilya. Painful niya sa kuha ang kinabuhi ang nilaon. Painful niya sa kuha sa inyong tapos sa kumpas. talaga dahil igamit ito ni Lord, pranasan din ako ng matindog. So, kung naluha-luha mong kamong anaay langit, isa na tinuon na na impirno. So, kung naluha-luha mong mga makasunod ba kami sa langit, isa na mong tinuon na isa na ang dalan, Jesus Christ ayun. Jesus Christ ayun ang dalan. Sa John 14:6, yun lang nga, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So, guys, isa lang requirements, Jesus Christ. Challenge ako, na kung nakakakalain na balaan, nakapabago sa mong tinabuhin, bata ninyo, bata na ganyan, mawala yung bago. Thay Jesus. Thay Jesus Christ, na mag-change mong tinabuhin, pala sa mag-change na sa buwan. So, for this is the Lord Dazo, servant of God. So, na-change ako kinabuhin din sa kapwa, Jesus Christ, so, to God be all the glory.
Okay, praise God. Now, ito'y bali. What's the message? Okay. Just like Manasseh, he repented. Si Caleb ko yun, well, he repented. And what was the response of God? He forgave. Now, you might think that Manasseh's repentance and God's forgiveness are unexpected. But you know what? Manasseh's life was changed. Kuya Lowell's life was changed. And God gave us a new start. Now, you might wonder this. How far would God do to get your attention? Have you come to your senses to surrender your life to Jesus? Ay, si Kuya Lowell to happen that I really remember. Ingo niya nga, ang pista daw, so the only man who touches my skin. Di ba? Pero yung hindi yung gagahapon, nita niyo naman, only Jesus touches my life. The question is, who touches yours? Okay? Are you any first-timers today? Or maybe you're just living your life as if okay lang? I think, come to realize this. You want to level up? You have to get down on your knees. And ask Jesus to change. We are looking at what was in the faith. But I changed him because of my life. Maybe because you're not surrendering your life to Jesus. You're still running your own life. When you run your own life, just like Manasseh, you're mocking God. You're still proud. But if you really wanted to humble yourself down, come before God, Lord, change me. Even my thoughts, my words, my actions, change me, Lord. Because I can't do it. Kung i-change mo si Kuya Lowell, kaya niyo i-change ang life. Kung i-change mo si Manasseh, kaya niyo i-change ang life. I don't want to live a simple life. I want to level up, Lord. Because ikaw ang makalevel up sa ako. But very wrong. You want to be down on your knees, repent of your sins, to humble, to be cleansed. Let's close to our prayer. If you have first-timers here tonight, today, not a first-timer, So anyway, let's close in word of prayer. Father, thank you so much, Lord, for the message. Indeed, we can truly be leveled up, Lord, to humble obedience, to down on our knees, Lord, so that we can see your grace, your mercy. Lord, your grace has been there all along in the Old Testament as what you have shown in the life of Manasseh, and true also in the life of Lowell. Lord, you have shown your grace, you have shown your mercy, and you have leveled him up, Lord, to the point where you want him to be. Lord, I pray that you will bless well and bless his hands, use him mightily, Father God, especially as well to others. Lord, I pray for those who are first timers here, or not the first timers here, they have been here in Elevate, and you have been coming here, and yet you are not sure if you're living a life pleasing to God. Why don't you pray this simple prayer? Lord, I want to be leveled up. But I don't want to be leveled up from my own. I want you, Lord, to level me up. Teach me, Lord, to humble myself before you and obey your word faithfully. And if I'm not sure of my salvation, Lord, I ask you to come into my life as my Lord, my Savior. I repent of all my sins, Lord, and ask you to change me to be the kind of person that you want me to be. I pray that you will teach me, Lord, to live a life that is pleasing to you. Thank you for forgiving all my sins, for coming into my life, being my Lord and my Savior, and for giving me.